أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء وخاتم المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا بالقاسم محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين. Dear sisters and brothers Iman, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Canada was shocked this week by the horrifying attack on a Muslim family in London, Ontario. Five members of a Muslim family had gone out for an evening walk in their neighborhood when a young fellow filled with hatred against Muslims mounted his truck on the curb and struck the Muslim family. In process, he killed four of them, ranging from the age 74 to 15 years old, and seriously injuring a 9-year-old boy. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to peace grant to those who were murdered brutally and to give complete and full recovery to the 9-year-old boy. The police and the government were quick in condemning it as a hate crime and an act of terrorism. Islamophobia is a reality. It cannot be ignored or pushed under the rug. There was a time when some politicians were not willing to recognize Islamophobia as a hate crime. But the massacre at the mosque in Quebec City 4 years ago and this recent tragedy has forced everyone to change their mind and face the challenge. From the Prime Minister of Canada, Justin Trudeau, and Ontario Premier Doug Ford to the Mayor and Police Chief of London, Ontario, all were very clear in acknowledging this incident as an act of terrorism motivated by hate. However, mere condemnation of what happened in London, Ontario is not sufficient. The government, the media, and the education system has to play their responsible role in instilling the value of multiculturalism and diversity. Remember the story of the private member's bill presented to the Canadian Parliament in 2017, known as Motion 103, that called on the government to condemn Islamophobia and all forms of systematic racism and religious discrimination? When this bill was presented by Iqra Khalid, the MP from Mississauga, there was an acrimonious debate about it. The motion was finally approved by a margin of 201 against 91. What do these numbers mean for us? It means that almost one-third of the MPs did not want to recognize Islamophobia as a problem. According to the Angus Reid poll on motion 103 taken at that time, 47% of Canadians were opposed to the motion, including the leadership of a very vocal minority religious community. If one-third of the MPs and almost half of the Canadians refuse to acknowledge the problem of Islamophobia as a hate crime, then it means that we collectively must do quite a lot to dispel the misinformation about Islam and Muslims. I therefore fully support the petition of the National Council of Canadian Muslims, NCCM, where it says, we call on all levels of government, federal, provincial, territorial, municipal, across the country to come together for a national action summit on Islamophobia to take immediate action on dismantling both violent forms of Islamophobia and systematic Islamophobia. I urge you to go to the NCCM's website and sign that petition. One of the arguments used in the debate against Motion 103 was that it will suppress the freedom of speech. By not taking the problem of Islamophobia seriously, the culture of hate grows among fringe elements who then take away the freedom of an evening stroll by a Muslim family in London and the freedom of a peaceful prayer in a mosque in Quebec City. So you have to make a choice what you are talking about. In chapter 5, verse 32 of the Quran, Almighty God reminds us of the message He gave to the Israelites in Torah, where He clearly says, "Man qatala nafsan bighayri nafsin aw fasadin fil ard fakanma qatala an-nasa jami'a." Whoever kills a person, not in retaliation for a person killed, nor for corruption in the society, it shall be as if he has killed the people all together. When this murderer killed 4 Muslims in London, Ontario, he did not only kill them. It was as if he killed all residents of London, all inhabitants of Ontario, all citizens of Canada. It was a crime against humanity. And so all of us must stand up against it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give courage and wisdom to those who are responsible to manage this country so that they may implement their duty of establishing justice for all, not only for the majority, but also for the minority, especially the visible minorities in Canada. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you all safe, and may He hasten the appearance of the Imam of the time, Ajalallahu ta'ala faraju sharif. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.